Welcome to Gig Country. Today, we're going to show you what you can expect on a typical fiber optic installation. Phase one, it starts with our engineers. The contractor will look over our plans with the engineering department to discern if there are any conflicts with any underground utilities, such as power, water, septic drains, water lines, etc. Once the contractor has determined the path, they will use a vibratory plow to install the underground fiber optic cable from the access pedestal at the road to the side of the house where the transition box will be located. Using this vibratory plow, the machine will slice through the soil with its blade while simultaneously placing the fiber optic cable underground by allowing the cable to pass through a chute built into the back of the plow blade. Generally, this cable will be installed at a depth of approximately 12 inches. The contractor may hand dig to negotiate around obstacles, such as the previously mentioned utilities, flower beds, decks, etc. After the cable is installed, the mound left behind the machine's plow blade will be packed and leveled by running over the mound with the machine's tires. Any dirt or bald spot that are left will be reseeded to establish grass. When plowing activities are complete, the contractor will dig the fiber optic cable into the access pedestal at the road and up to the home at the transition box location and leave cable at each end for the fiber technician and the broadband technician to perform splicing at their respective locations. Phase two, fiber splicing at the access pedestal. When arriving at the access pedestal location, the fiber technician will determine if splicing can be made inside of a splicing trailer or if it will have to be done outside. In this example, the splicing can be performed inside the trailer. For many of our areas, this will not be the case, and it will have to be performed outside on a table. This will require ideal weather conditions to ensure optimal splice results. At this point, the fiber technician will remove all cables from the access pedestal and place them inside the fiber splicing trailer. The fiber technician will then strip the outer covering off the cable using a knife to access the buffer tubes and fibers inside. Once the tubes containing the fiber optic strands are exposed, the framework of the splice case will be installed into the cables and fiber optic strand tubes placed in the fiber trays. The splice case will protect the fibers from water, rodents, and hazards caused by periodic movement. The technician will then strip off the tubing containing the fibers, strip the coating off the fibers, and then place a heat shrink tube on one side of the fibers. After the fibers are stripped, the fibers will be placed in holders and cut precisely using a fiber cleaver. The fibers are then placed inside of a fusion splicer using the fiber holders. At this point, the fusion splicer will align the ends and splice the fibers using electric arcing technology. Once the fusion splice is complete, the fiber technician will place the heat shrink over the splice and place it in an oven on the splicer to activate the heat shrink tubing. When the heat shrink is finished, the heat shrink tube will be placed in the fiber tray located in the splice case frame. The heat shrink and fiber tray both help to organize and stabilize the splice to avoid movement and potential breakage. With the splicing complete, the fiber technician will put a cover on the splice case, coil up the excess fiber, and replace it back into the fiber access pedestal, completing the splicing procedure. Phase 3, basic installation at the home. Citizens will need to install the fiber optic drop on the outside of your home with a transition box to protect it from the elements. Once the transition box is mounted, we like to discuss the proper placement of the ONT inside the home with the homeowner. Proper placement of the ONT will help to ensure the best Wi-Fi coverage in your home so that you can stream seamlessly if you choose to stream media. The citizen's technician will now install a new fiber optic cable from the transition box on the outside of your home to the connection point on the inside of your home. As every home is unique, the citizen's technician will discuss the entry point of this fiber optic line before doing any drilling on your home. Once the fiber cable has been installed to the proper location, the technician will proceed to install a fiber optic jack. The fiber optic jack provides the signal to the ONT with a fiber patch cable. Once this patch cable is hooked into the ONT, the technician will test the gigabit connection, provide ample education on your new equipment and clean up the work area and be on their way. At this point, you are now a Citizens Gigabit Fiber Service customer. Welcome to Gig Country. Try to set the night on fire.